6:55 in your news to go this morning. A Minnesota State Patrol trooper is charged with a crime himself.
Kai Edwards is in the newsroom with what he's accused of doing.
Sean Barta is charged with criminal sexual conduct. Charging documents say he sexually assaulted a 14-year-old girl who is described as cognitively delayed. But she came forward, sparking this investigation. Barta denies the accusations and is set to appear in court 6 weeks from today.
Today, Governor Walz will tour the damage left behind by massive flooding in southern Minnesota. He'll make stops in Manterville and Byron this morning. Both areas were hit hard by heavy rain, which caused damage to roads and fields there. In June, floodwater swept away 50 cows in Byron. During that month, residents saw 9 inches of rain.
Wow. Well, down in the Gulf, we will expect that Barry will officially form and be named today. But here at home, it is quiet and it is the best day of the 7-day forecast. Low humidity and 80s, but then headed through the weekend, the humidity is increasing, storm chances start to increase, and then a heat wave here that takes us through the next week to 10 days. 90s for several days.
Heat wave, not bad. And get out today. It's gorgeous out.
Absolutely.
We are keeping an eye on this crash. 94 looks like at Highway 25, really causing some stop and go traffic for folks. So this looks like it is just before the Monticello exit, so 94. So just a heads up for that if that is your route this morning. We did have some slowdowns also through the Lowry Hill Tunnel, which is pretty typical. And then 494 near the airport this morning.
That spot, 394. Oh, that is the worst.
It's a nightmare. Hey, coming up on Facebook Live, you guys, we're talking about that woman from Duluth who went topless on one of the beaches. Apparently, it's legal. You can do it.
And people are talking about it. We'll see you back on Facebook Live.
Gray area.
Have a good day. Enjoy outside.
Go topless. Why not?
Woo!
Thursday morning.
We're happy you're here with us on our Facebook Live. Laura is in for Sven. She'll be right back and join us in just a second.
I just wanted to put up the latest on what's going on in the Gulf.
Okay. Sven is actually in Lake Benton. Mm-hmm. He was doing a story about a butterfly there that is extinct in Iowa and Illinois, but it's kind of thriving and trying to survive here in prairie grass in Minnesota. So he's going to have that story on our website. Before we get to the forecast, Laura, we got to talk about the story out of Duluth. And everyone's talking about it online. So this woman out of Duluth, she decided to go topless at a local beach there near Lake Superior. And this other woman with her children saw and was like, ma'am, you're offending. Like, my children are seeing this. Can you put a top on? The police were called. Mm-hmm. And the women kind of, that woman that was topless kind of schooled the police.
Yeah.
Right?
And she said, you know, I know the law. The law says that I basically, like, it doesn't say what your private parts are.
Right.
And so she said, I can do this. And the police kind of went back and forth with her. Eventually, though, she did put her top back on. You know, a lot of people are talking about it now.
So the law, it states a person should not willfully and lewdly expose the person's body or the private parts. And that's where the gray area is like, well, what's considered a private part? And we got so many kind of funny comment. And sometimes I'm like, that's a good point.
We've chuckled all morning about
it. Pull up your comments from our sunrisers. Mary says, if there are kids and families around, it's not right. She can tan in her private backyard if she wants to go topless.
All right. And Karen Wright, she says, many, many other countries allow it. Grow up, people.
People are weird about the boob, I tell you. Noah says, the real shame is that she's subjected to this spectacle for doing what men can do by rote.
And let's see, Kim Lamb Johnson, no, not on a family beach. Yeah, so we're getting kind of a mixed bag here with what people are saying.
Yeah.
Kathy says, think of everyone else, have some self-respect, common decency.
I have two little girls, and I personally would not be offended by that, and I'm such a fan of some of the comments we've had this morning of, like, this is what
human
your body is.
Anatomy,
Guess what? Yeah, you're gonna grow boobs someday, too, and that's great.
Yeah.
That's okay. Like, you don't have to be ashamed of your body.
Yeah.
And I like that. Yeah, that's so true.
Regardless of if it's right to go topless or not, like, I think that's a good message to maybe
embrace. The ones
that make it more normal, too, and be like, it's okay. It's
okay. They're boobs. And some of the comments that made us, that we were giggling at, were ones where it's like, well, I've seen men with larger breasts.
Absolutely.
And some women going on a beach, and it looks Which just like true. A normal boob.
Yeah. You know, one of the things that this organization that follows different states in the country that have laws around topless and nudity and those sorts of things, but they said that Minnesota has a really ambiguous law. Yeah. And so we see that in this case where this woman's like, I'm actually not breaking the law. Police didn't ticket her because they said, you know, she actually isn't. So
right.
like, it's ambiguous, yeah. But, you know, I think this is also in the same vein as, you know, some of the things that we've talked about and heard about in the past where it's women who are breastfeeding out in public, you know? It's kind of like, it's a natural thing. It happens. Yep. It's a boob. It's fine.
People, a lot of you are commenting on this right now. Some are inappropriate, you guys. Clean it up on this Thursday morning.
Let's hear some.
Anthony says no one should be shirtless in public. Oh, or maybe he's saying no, men like men
too.
And women.
Okay.
Okay. Lisa says good morning. Girl power this morning.
That's Woo-hoo. Right.
Hey, Lisa.
The Beyonce song is running in my mind all
morning. Around the world, girls. Okay. Done singing that song. Susan says people in Europe don't get upset over the natural body. In America, people have so many hang-ups. Mm-hmm. Other people were very upset about it. Brenda's saying absolutely not. Mm-hmm. Warren said less attractive women will be both more offended and more insecure. Blame it on men. Oh, that's kind of an interesting... Okay.
Interesting take, sure. Yeah, we kind of... All
Either way,
the place.
It's kind of like you're on one side or the other.
Yeah. All right. So it was kind of Janice Shortle did a full interview with this woman who went topless on Breaking the News last night. If you haven't seen it, you can get it at KareLevin.com right now. It's pretty humorous, but it also talks about, you know, all the different sides, of course.
Yeah.
So tune into that. Moving on. Hey, do you have a dog?
His name's Teddy.
We have a dog.
You do have a dog?
Yeah, a little
Sharpei.
She's not little.
Sharpei. Well, today is National All-American Pet Day.
Yeah.
And there's so many days for pets with these national days. But All-American Pet. And
well, we I just said any reason to post a picture of Teddy. Sure, absolutely.
Do you have one, like, in...
It's on my Twitter.
America?
I got it.
If you want to check it out. No, right. Not in any sort of, like, American flag. Yeah, but it's just Teddy. It's fine.
Are we going to pull up those photos for folks?
Oh,
hello.
Oh, cute.
Two.
Brandy Betcher.
Samantha Gordon.
Yeah, I saw a lot of people with little scarves. I think that's
for the
cute.
U.S. women's national team. All right.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, Crosby's in the sink.
Doesn't Crosby's that make you want to turn it off?
Yeah. All right, Erica has a kitty. Yeah, kitty pee.
Pee-wee.
Chillin'.
Kitty.
And Lynette.
Is this from winter time? Oh, this Looks is she's like just it. Sharing photos now of her babies. Little puppy babies.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
there's a good picture for today.
Okay, is it fine that dogs eat ice cream? Or do they get like an upset stomach? I see so many dogs eating ice cream photos, and I was like, is that okay for dogs to have?
I always look up like if I have strawberries or something, like, I can't remember.
Because I know
strawberries are okay.
Yogurt is
right.
Dairy,
grapes are not.
Dogs, I'm just like,
I
don't stinky.
Dairy in my own body, let alone my
dog. Oh, yeah.
But that's another debate.
Vegan.
That's another debate.
We got a vegan on our hands. Rebecca says Murphy or cool. Oh, that's a spot to cool down.
At first I was like, where is the dog?
Where's the dog? I will say Laura made a cashew milk.
I did.
I never had it before. It was really good.
Yeah,
I need to try
it. I was surprised
it.
You made it from scratch.
Mm-hmm.
I brought it in and it was gone. I would have shared it with you, but Alicia kept pouring more.
Can I dare you,
Alicia?
I know, I took a lot of it. Well, I need it. I like it to be a creamy.
No, I do too. I do like half cashew milk.
I probably should have done half. I'm used to half and half.
Right.
Which, you know, is delicious. But I would love to book you on Care in the Kitchen next week. Can you come on?
Oh, cool. I will.
It's on the spot.
I will.
Make
something
vegan?
I can make I will. We can make the cashew milk and then maybe make something with it or I don't know. We'll figure it out.
All right. So you just heard it here first. She's going to come next week, Care in the Kitchen. Meanwhile, speaking of Care in the Kitchen, you guys, I had to go. Remember that viral pizza place with the dill pickle pizza?
Yes.
It literally it has 12 million views online. They went viral. They were in the Daily Mail. They were over in Brazil. Like, word got out about this Minnesota pizza joint. So I was like, I got to try this pizza. What makes it so good? Take a look.
So I thought, okay, well, what can I do to be different? So I created it. It's got garlic dill sauce, Canadian bacon that's been smoked for 48 hours, two layers of pickles, mozzarella cheese, fresh dill. What more do you need?
Oh, yeah.
We gotta see this shot.
And there's the slow-mo of me mowing. I ate 3 slices just to get this shot for you guys. You're welcome.
Beautiful.
Poor thing.
So do you guys think she liked it or what? I don't know.
You gotta tune in on our Facebook, YouTube page. We talk more about, you know, like the how it went viral this guy. It's a small pizza shop in Minnesota that's like, who knew that putting dill pickles on a pizza would make it go viral? And he actually based it off Minnesota sushi. Mm-hmm. Do you know what that is, Gia?
No.
Minnesota sushi it's ham. It's like a pickle roll up.
I use corned beef, or in former life.
And I was like, wait a minute.
Corned beef, but ham or corned beef.
Ham with a cream cheese spread, and then you roll a pickle in it, and then you like chop it up, and people serve it.
It's so good.
That sounds really good.
Good.
Okay.
I'm going to make it for you at some point. Okay. It's one of our like family staples at any gathering. Yeah. Pickle roll ups or
they are kind of a pain to make.
So that's why he was like, I want to make it based on a Minnesota type thing.
Oh,
and
nice.
Yeah,
I like
tune in
it.
9 KARE 11 Facebook page.
And you know, it's, you brought some in for the station because you don't know.
I'm sorry.
You don't know how Alicia felt about that yet, but you did bring some back to the station, and a lot of people I heard they were raving
some
about
it. Some mixed reviews. Yeah. I brought some into the morning meeting with Jana Shortle and all the breaking news folks. They were like, "Get that out of here!"
They're like, "That's not pizza."
Yeah. So tune in to 9 o'clock for that. It was interesting.
Perfect. Okay.
On a slightly more serious note, I just want to do a quick update with what we have going on in the Gulf of Mexico. So this is a brand new update in from the National Hurricane Center at 7 here. And it's not named a storm yet, so not officially Barry, but expecting that to happen before the end of the day today. As it's moving off to the west, it'll take a turn to the north, and the coast of Louisiana will likely have a Category 1 hurricane making landfall before it all pushes on in here. And the heaviest rain happening from New Orleans and east as that does so. Trying to figure out what button I need to hit to show our 7-day forecast here. Okay, well, whatever. What we can expect here today is a lot of sunshine. Right now it's 66 degrees.
Not bad.
The dew point is 60, and this is as humid as it gets. From here on out, we are talking the temperature is rising, but the dew point's decreasing. So 82 degrees today. And if you're wondering about your weekend plans, there's some isolated storms tomorrow, but those are like midday afternoon. And then Sunday, stuff not till late. So most of the weekend is just hot and humid.
Yeah. So get out, enjoy today, have a beer.
Oh gosh, at least for like 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Like, come on, people.
Hit up a patio, a lake, a pool. It's going to be nice. The humidity thing, I'm not a big fan of the humidity, but today is going to be my kind of day.
Mm-hmm. Right. Like, I don't want to hear one complaint.
Sunscreen, though. Right?
But this weekend, I'm going to start complaining again.
Yeah. Okay.
Just kidding.
Hey, that's what we do here in Minnesota.
Yeah, we complain when the weather's like
too
perfect
cold
or too hot. It's a weird thing. All right. Hey, that's a wrap. Happy Thursday. We hope you come back and hang out with us.
I'm not.
You're not?
No. Not coming back tomorrow.
All right. Oh, Sven's back. Yeah. Darn. Just kidding. Hey, have a good Thursday.
Bye.